I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. Hi. Did you know that April showers can bring more than just Mayflowers? It's true. Excessive rainfall can cause landslides. Hi, everyone. My name is Autumn, not Spring. But today, I would like to tell you all just a little bit more about landslides and how they occur, as well as introduce you all to the landslides issue in NASA's Earth Observatory for Kids periodical. Now, these issues come out monthly, and this particular issue that I am referring to is called Landslides, Earth on the Move. It's available online. It's free. You can download it as a PDF, or you can print it off, as I have done here. Now, this is the activity we're going to be doing today, and it's DIY science, how much rain will cause a landslide. Now, it's a really, really easy activity to do. You just need some simple materials that you can find in your home, such as a milk carton with the cap, markers, pair of scissors, some dirt, it could be sand or straight up soil, gravel, you decide. You will also need maybe something to prop up the milk carton. We'll get to that in a second. A container to hold the landslide in, and a spray bottle with water in it. And this is going to be your rain. Now what you need to do first off is take your milk carton. I just dropped something. You're gonna take your milk carton and use your scissors, and you're gonna cut top of the milk carton all the way around until you remove the front. Then you're gonna take your dirt and your gravel, and you're going to pour it into the now open milk carton. And this is going to be your land. I'm just gonna pat it in there. You can see I got dirt and a root. I'm gonna take that out. But yes, I've got dirt in my open milk carton. Just make some space here. And I'm gonna take my marker, and I pick any color you want. I just happen to pick green. And you're gonna mark on the inside. So this is gonna help measure where your dirt was before the rain happened, before the precipitation fell. Now to do the next step, you're gonna take your container, and you're going to place your milk carton landslide in the container. And I'm using a cup to help me prop it up because my container is a little bit big. And you are going to then create a slope with the angle. So here I have about a 45 degree angle. And depending on the slope of a hill will determine how much damage occurs when a landslide happens, how fast that land is gonna flow down when the rain occurs. So I know my water bottle fell down, so paint on a sec. Back. So this is gonna be my rain. So now it's up to you, as you do this experiment, to make predictions. So in the activity itself, you will find an area where you get to make predictions about how much rain do you think it's gonna take to cause a landslide. Also, something to consider is what should your mixture be for your soil? Should you do straight up soil? Should you do straight up sand? Perhaps a mixture of the two. And then determine from that test, that experiment, which is better, which is gonna hold up better. When excessive rain occurs. And this is something to know and take note of, because in the future, when you might be in a garden, perhaps on a hillside, you might want to think about what kind of soil mixture you should do so that it stays intact when heavy rain occurs. So I'm going to go ahead and give this a go.
All right, starting to spray. As you can see, some movement happening as little rivulets of water come flowing down our land. Starting to see some sliding. Wait, there it goes. Slump and landslide.
I invite you all to give this a try at home. Make those predictions and see how much rain will cause a landslide. Thank you for joining, everyone. Be sure and check us out at NASA's Earth Observatory for Kids. You can search that up just by searching EO Kids or by going to www.earthobservatory.nasa.gov/EOKids. That's it for today. Thanks for joining. Bye-bye.